Next, the raw ethic. Have you read it here before? You have. Let's give him a hand.
Hey, how y'all doing tonight? So this is one that I've written called The Petrified Dream. Last night as I drifted to sleep, I felt my body creep into a parallel dimension beyond my comprehension. The position at the foot of my bed as a smog did rise was about a dozen red eyes ushering in the hellish tunnel that funneled from my mind, distorting voices in my head that mumbled deriding curses and prophecy, properly writing verses on the drywall, calling a herd of flying creatures bearing semblance to prehistoric reptiles with bat wings and forked tails, forcing me out of bed. I almost failed, almost impaled by talons and teeth. From beneath, a ravenous beast slithered in my ear, and out my balcony door I stepped 5 feet from where I slept, although with legs my bed had crept away on its own, leaving in its place a pile of bones, and my bedroom conjured from an unknown throne, out from which the scorpion's tail flailed, giving a sting, and these are the things that it said. The shepherds smell like blood. You can see the thick crimson dripping like blood off their gloves. They're grabbing, snatching up these sheep with no love, stamping feet on the ground, cause the sound of your speech sounds like bleeding, every day. Speaking of animals caged, the blood trails I followed up to this stage were used by the sheep who were used to eat by the shepherds who under the skin are nothing but ravenous leopards, who con those who don't know that religion is more than just a weapon. The morals of society are poor. This recession is more than money. Its principles prove that man's conscience isn't invincible, divisible by sin, subtracted by demonic entities, move with dark energy, multiplied endlessly by events of the last days, where life is a fast maze, and all I see is rats looking for scraps, falling in traps, severed heads from books containing scrolls rolled closed by ugly trolls. Under bridges and witches are now the teachers in the public school system, pumping poisonous knowledge like pissing into the wisdom watering youth. So who the hell is in touch with the truth amidst these confused excuses called men and women, often going under the guises of pastors, professors, and poets, pretending to know the times, the clever rhymes and intelligent sounding lines, neither define nor satisfy the endless misery of lost yards and failed marriages, miscarriages, and abortions. Extortion of pills by the addicted, dysfunctional sexual predators, protecting innocent children from their parental homes. Tell me where this world's morals have gone, and all this is warped images in the mind of a man who's alone.